So Mission Control is one of the most powerful features of macOS. Yet a lot of people don't use it because it can seem very complicated. There are lots of different ways to arrange it. There are a lot of shortcuts and commands and things like that. So let's take a look at a very simple example that can get you started. So here I've got a typical setup where I can see mail, I can see messages, and another app, say reminders, all at the same time on my desktop. You may have a similar arrangement on your desktop. But this is not where you're getting work done. This is more for communications. To get work done, you've got a document open in Pages, which you can bring up, and a document in Numbers. And if you want to get back to all that other stuff, you would use, say, Command H to hide Numbers, Command H to hide Pages. You get back to this, and now you have to go Pages and Numbers again to get back to work. So a better way to do this would be to put Pages and Numbers where you're getting your work done on a separate desktop. We're going to use Mission Control for that. So I'm going to use the Control key, not the Command key, but the Control key and up arrow. And that will take me to Mission Control. And I can see I have one desktop here at the top, but all my apps are shown here with these little blue boxes around them as I move my mouse there. Now I want to put these two apps, my work apps, on a separate desktop. So I'm going to hit the plus button here at the top right. It creates desktop number two. And I'm simply going to drag Pages and drag Numbers to desktop number two. Now I've got desktop one and desktop two. I can click either of these here at the top to go to them. So I'll go to desktop one and it looks like it did before. I have these three apps here. But if I want to get to my work, all I need to do is use Control and right arrow and it slides over to desktop number two where I've got Pages and Numbers. If I want to get back to desktop one, Control and left arrow. So I can go back and forth between these very easily. I get my work done over here and want to get a notification that I have a new email or new message or I want to add something to reminders, I can use Control left arrow and I'm at this desktop. So let's take this one step further. Of course you're going to have to browse the web. Maybe you're doing it sometimes for the work you're doing. Sometimes you're doing it just to check up on things. So I'm going to launch Safari here and it's going to cover these windows. Now it's getting crowded on desktop one again. Now I could put Safari on its own desktop, desktop number three, but an easier way to do it will be to make it full screen, which gives it its own desktop in one step. I'm going to hit this green plus button right here and now you can see it's full screen. I can still get to the menu bar by moving my cursor to the top and waiting a second. I can still get to the dock by moving down to the bottom, but I have a full screen just dedicated to Safari. Now how does this look in Mission Control? If I use Control up arrow, I could see I've got a desktop one, a desktop two, and Safari there in between them. So I go back to Safari and I can use Control and left arrow to get to desktop one, then right arrow takes me back to Safari, right arrow takes me to my work, and left arrow back to Safari. Control up arrow takes me back to Mission Control where I can actually move these windows. I can move the desktop to the right here. So I put Safari at the end of the line. So now I can go desktop one, work, and then Safari. If I ever want to change things, all I need to do is close one of the desktops or all of them. So I can say close desktop two and that goes away. And now everything is crowded back onto desktop one. Over here with Safari, I can close that and it sticks Safari back on that same desktop as well. I'm now back to one desktop. Everything's crowded in there. So you can again see the advantage of having all these things on multiple desktops. I hope this gives you the encouragement you need to try Mission Control out. Try working with it and see how it can improve your workflow. And once you get the hang of this, there are lots of other controls and ways you can manipulate windows and apps inside of Mission Control. Thank you.